Local views. Canterbury Mornings with Chris Lynch. Thanks to Team Hutchinson Ford, the home of Roush performance upgrades for Ford Mustangs. Tuam Street in the city. Newstalk ZB.
It is Newstalk ZB with Chris. It is time for our very popular segment. We're catching up with the Chamber of Commerce CEO, Leeann Watson. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Chris.
Election 2020 is finally out of the way. What is your reaction to the results from a business point of view?
Yeah, well, look, I obviously followed the campaigning pretty closely, and obviously the election outcomes on Saturday night pretty closely as well, like many New Zealanders, no doubt. And I think, Labor's win was probably not a surprise to many people. I think the magnitude of the win and some of the results of in different electoral seats was probably a bit of a surprise to some people. And look, I think by and large, in an environment where we've still got a high degree of uncertainty around the COVID environment, at least we're now in a position where we've got the election outcome results that provides a degree of certainty and possibly a degree of continuity as well, having the same Prime Minister.
Yeah. So now we know what's happening. So do you think it will be business as usual? There won't be that sort of sense of underconfidence or underperforming because we've got a government that is steady as she goes.
Yeah, look, we know that businesses do thrive in an environment of stability and certainty. So I think this will definitely help businesses move forward and make decisions that perhaps have been, just on hold a little. I mean, COVID is still in our environment, so that, as I said, that does still provide a degree of unpredictability moving forward and for the foreseeable future. But I do think that businesses will expect also from this government, if they are going to basically go alone, they've got the mandate to govern alone, they will expect to see some acceleration in terms of our economic recovery. So there is an expectation that we will get a new approach and we'll see some changes moving forward.
I was speaking to Labor's campaign manager, Megan Woods, yesterday, and she said she believed the reason why some people voted for Labor was because Labor had a plan. I don't know if I could say what the plan is for the economic recovery. Do you know?
Yeah, no, look, we've talked about this before.
I'm not being facetious. Yeah. I'm trying to understand what is Labor's plan for economic recovery.
And no, look, that's not really clear. And so certainly what I would like to hear and very soon, is what is that plan? What are the details? We need to make sure that industries have more clarity around what the expectations are from this government around certain things. We need to make sure we understand around the creation of jobs, more clarity on infrastructure investment and the pipeline that will actually help create new jobs, it will help increase productivity, and it will help really unlock some investment across our communities. So we need to know more about that. We need to know how they're going to support small business and what does that look like. How are they going to cut regulations? How are they going to reform the RMA? So now's the time where we want to start seeing some of those details come through from this government.
I just want to put a caveat on that. I don't think the national government either provided a plan. They keep saying we've got a plan. I would ask, Collins what that plan was, and she would say it's about creating jobs. Then how do you create jobs? And then there was kind of a nothing that went with that. I think it's but also to credit both political parties, I would say probably the reason being too is it's hard to make a plan when we're still in an international environment of uncertainty.
Yep. And look, there is a very real risk that we get into a reactionary mode where we're dealing with the here and now and we're not keeping one eye on the long-term future. But actually, we have to expect from our central government that is their role, to create that long-term economic recovery plan with some detail. That's what the businesses of this world have to do. So we need to expect that from this government. And the sooner that we can get some more clarity around that, the better. I mean, we've done, through the Business New Zealand Network, our organisation's been involved in pulling together, I guess, a bit of an ask of the government, and it does provide some real clarity around things like having a long-term investment in good quality infrastructure that will create jobs, it will provide the opportunity to build skills, it will provide the opportunity for private sector investment and unlocking some of those opportunities to enable our communities to be well-resourced. So there's definitely information that's available, and actually we look forward to continuing the really good constructive relationship that we've had with the government over many, many years to help them do that. They need to engage with the business community to come up with that plan.
Leeann, I don't know if some of your members are saying this, but certainly the people I've spoken to, including NewstalkZB clients and customers, and they've been saying they've been doing a roaring trade. Mm. And in fact, I was in Hamner Springs. I said this to the audience before, so I'll excuse the audience for me for being boring here. And I was speaking to a restaurateur who said, keep the borders closed. She said she's never had it so good. business is up. It's consistent. It's not just during the school holidays or any public holidays. They are always busy. And she says because people are spending their dollars in New Zealand. I've got a friend who works in the skincare, cosmetic industry, what have you. She's getting what's known. I think the Herald did quite an interesting story on this. The Zoom effect. You've got women who are thinking, oh, I don't look good. I need to go to the cosmetic surgery. She says she's up by 20 to 30% this time last year. Skin cancer, people going getting their moles checked is up 40% because people are using their discretionary income, their money that they would have spent on the European trip to look after themselves. Yep. Are you seeing that? Is that the kind of vibe? Is that the feeling you're getting from some of your members?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the figures back that up. We've had some really good results in terms of, you know, retail spend right across many sectors over the last few months, which is really positive. I think, you know, the term discretionary dollar is the thing that I would just be a little cautious about. You know, we do know that there are some sectors and some businesses that are still struggling. You know, I hope that, you know, over the coming sort of couple of quarters that we've got, you know, the last quarter of this year and, of course, the first quarter of next year, we'll continue to see that really strong, positive economic recovery. It's as long as people have got that discretionary dollar in their pocket, they will continue to do that. But I think long term, we do need the borders open because it's not just about the tourists. It's actually about getting the right skills into this country. We do have some challenges in some sectors where they need the right skills to support our economic recovery in some of those sectors. So this is about a very carefully managed reopening of the borders using, you know, different criteria and different thresholds to make sure we get the right people here.
We will get there. And I think with summer on the way, that will probably add to a busy time for many people.
Absolutely, right? Yeah.
Leeann Watson, Chief Executive of the Canterbury Employers Chamber of Commerce. Always good to have your insight. Thanks so much for your time this morning.
Thanks, Chris.
That is our show. We are back again tomorrow, everybody, from 9 a.m. Don't forget, if it's a